Hi, welcome to Sunil Maths Tutorial, Abstract Algebra, Group Theory, class number 31. In this class, we discuss about a theorem which is stated here. A non-empty subset H of a finite group G is a subgroup if and only if A comma B belongs to H implies AB belongs to H. In another words, a necessary and sufficient condition for a complex H of a finite group G to be a subgroup of G is that A belongs to H, B belongs to H implies AB belongs to H. You observe that in the previous class also we learned a similar theorem. In that theorem, complex is finite one. That subset H is finite, but we don't know about the group, it is finite or infinite. The finite complex is a subgroup of G if and only if A comma B belongs to H implies AB belongs to H. Condition is same. But there in the statement, H is finite. But here, the group is finite. The given group capital G is finite. That is very, very important difference between this and previous theorem. You observe that. Yes, let us start the proof of the theorem. Capital G be a finite group. And H be a non-empty subset of G. The word finite group is very, very important one. G be a finite group means it consists of only limited number of elements or finite number of elements. We have to show that H is a subgroup of G implies and implied by A belongs to H, B belongs to H implies AB belongs to H. First we take H is a subgroup of G. We prove this condition. And in the converse part, we take the condition and we prove that H is a subgroup of G. Suppose H is a subgroup of G. Suppose capital H is a subgroup of G. We know that every subgroup is itself a group. That is, H is itself a group, H is itself a group with respect to same binary operation in G. With respect to same binary operation in capital G. And since H is itself a group, therefore, by closure axiom, by closure axiom in capital G we have, by closure axiom in capital G, in capital H, not in G, in capital H we have A belongs to H comma B belongs to H implies AB belongs to H. You observe that we take H is a subgroup of G and we prove the condition. We assume that H is a subgroup of G. We prove this mathematical condition. This is the first part of the theorem. And in the converse part, we assume this condition. We prove that H is a subgroup of G. Let us start proving the converse, which is very, very important and lengthy one. Converse of the theorem. Suppose H is a non-empty subset of capital G satisfying the condition A belongs to H comma B belongs to H implies AB belongs to H. Let it be condition number 1, equation number 1. A belongs to H comma B belongs to H implies AB belongs to H. We have to prove that H is a subgroup of G. H is a subgroup of capital G. Yes. From equation 1, A comma B belongs to H implies AB belongs to H. Therefore, H satisfy closure axiom. H satisfy closure axiom with respect to multiplication. With respect to multiplication. From equation 1, A comma B belongs to H implies AB belongs to H. Therefore, H satisfy closure axiom with respect to multiplication. So, first axiom is over. Closure axiom satisfied by H. Since H is subset to G, what it means? All elements of H are elements of G. All elements of H are elements of G. And elements of G satisfies closure axiom. All elements of H are elements of G. And elements of G satisfy associative axiom with respect to multiplication. Therefore, elements of H also satisfy associative axiom. Elements of H also satisfy associative axiom with respect to multiplication. Now you observe that H satisfies two axioms. H satisfies the closure axiom. Elements of H satisfies the associative axiom. Condition number 1, closure axiom. Condition number 2, associative axiom. Next, we prove the identity axiom or existence of identity. Next, we prove that existence of identity. Let us take an element, small a belongs to capital H. And H is subset to G. What it means? A belongs to G. And G is finite group. G is finite group. You observe the point by point. Concentrate on this. A belongs to H. H is subset to G. Automatically A belongs to G. In the given statement, G is a finite group. We know that the order of an element, is finite if the group is finite. Clearly observe the point. The order of an element is finite if the group is finite. Therefore, order of A is finite. Take order of A is equals to n, which implies as a power n is equals to e. Comma, where E is identity in capital G. Identity element in capital G. Since H satisfy closure axiom with respect to multiplication. Therefore, A, A square, A cube, and so on, A power n also belongs to H by closure axiom. By closure axiom. By applying closure axiom, all these elements A, A square, A cube and so on, A power N also belongs to H. A power N belongs to H means, A power N belongs to H means, what is the value of A power N? E. E belongs to H. Therefore, identity element exists in capital H. This is condition number 3. Already we proved that H satisfies closure axiom, H satisfies associative axiom. Now we prove that H satisfies identity axiom also. So let it, the remaining is H satisfies the inverse axiom. Let us take an element A belongs to H. By closure axiom, A into A also belongs to H. What it means? A square belongs to H, A cube belongs to H, and so on. A power N minus 1 also belongs to H. All these elements belong to H because of by closure axiom. Now you observe that. Let us take one condition. A into A power N minus 1. A into A power N minus 1. You get A power N, which is equals to E. Implies as small a into A power N minus 1 is equals to E, comma E is identity in H. You observe that we take A belongs to H. A power N minus 1 also belongs to H, such that their product is equals to E. Therefore, the inverse of A is A power N minus 1. The inverse of A is A power N minus 1 belongs to H. This shows us every element of capital H has inverse. Therefore, every element of capital H has inverse in capital H. This is condition number 4. You observe that. This is condition number 4. We prove that H satisfies closure axiom, H satisfies associative axiom, identity element exists in H, and we prove that every element of H has inverse in H. So H satisfies all the 4 axioms of a group. Therefore, H is a group with respect to multiplication. H is a group with respect to multiplication and H subset to G. Therefore, H is a subgroup of G. Our aim is also same. This completes the proof. These 2 theorems are very similar to one another. This theorem and its previous theorem are similar to one another. Here in this theorem, the group is finite. In the previous theorem, the complex means H is finite. Observe the difference between these 2 theorems and practice these proofs. These are very, very important theorems to your end semester examination also.